Well, now we want to talk about the deputies who died in that attack.
They leave behind their relatives and their law enforcement family. These are their pictures. Marvin Williams and Chase Whitebird had no idea what waited for them in that Seminole home. Eyewitness News 5's Linda Mattis talked to their families and has more on our big story.
For several hours after the shooting, many people didn't know exactly what happened at the house on 2nd Street, not even relatives.
Somebody was shot and somebody was medified to city is all we heard.
Still, everyone came together. Law enforcement officers may not have known who was shot, but they showed up by the dozens.
You can imagine, you know that two of your own are dead, and the person who you believe did it inside.
The standoff continued.
I don't think Chase and Marvin had a clue that was going to happen.
Then the mourning process began.
We can't really change anything. He was doing his job, and I have a lot of respect for all the law officers.
Seminole County Sheriff's Deputy Marvin Williams was 43 years old, and the deputy who died with him, Chase Whitebird, was 23. Chase's uncle says both families are close.
Marvin kind of took Chase under his wing.
Chase even dated Marvin's daughter in high school. When Chase joined the sheriff's department last year, his uncle says the two grew even closer. Then they both responded to the call that's now bringing law enforcement and their loved ones together. Linda Mattis, Eyewitness News 5.
And at this point, the families have not set funeral arrangements for the deputies.